Glenn Martin Photos here. I'm wandering around in the cork forest in the Arboretum here in Canberra. And today I'm out shooting mushrooms.
Say hello to my little friend!
Like always, I'm going to show you how my camera is set up, what I'm doing, some settings. And I also want to show you the difference that aperture can make in the depth of field for your photos. So why don't we have a look at what I've got set up. Here's my camera. And there's my subject. Now, people knowing more than I do about mushrooms will be able to tell you what it is, but the point is, it's a pretty red one. Little bit late in the season to get these, unfortunately. Most of them are split, but this is a good little example. I've got my camera very low to the ground. You can see my tripod splayed right out. This is a Manfrotto 190 tripod. It's excellent. You can really spread those legs out so you can get close to the ground and close to your subject. If we're going to be doing up close photography, you'd normally want a macro lens so you can get really close. This is not a macro. This is my trusty 24 to 70 mil Canon lens, but I've gotten close enough that it will at least fill the frame. To begin with, on the back, I'm shooting at f13. I've set my white balance to shade because that's what I'm in. And because I'm using a tripod, I've used my ISO at 100. So 100 is going to be the cleanest, richest image your camera will do. But it does mean that if I just meter my shot, you see here it says 1.3 seconds. No way I can do that handheld. Let's go into live view on the back of a camera and you can see my subject. Now, I've manually focused this by zooming in on the mushroom. And I actually want to get it a little bit up the top for my focus, so I've got a decent depth of field on it. And also, you see my histogram? It's slightly to the left. So what I'm going to do is actually expose to the right, which is to say deliberately overexpose the image to what the camera thinks. This will just make it a bit brighter. You will notice that my 1.4 seconds has gone to 2 seconds down here. So I still really need that tripod. So let's take a quick shot. Oh, and you'll notice I've got a 2 second timer. So after I let go of the trigger, the camera is as still as possible. So let's just do that real quick. Okay, so we'll just have a quick preview. Zoom in. I had some flashing highlights there, so I've gone a bit high, but we're nicely in focus, so that's good. Interestingly though, have a look at the background. That flashing there is the highlights, what I said, so overexposing, but the background of the image, it's not totally in focus, but it's pretty clear. So let's change a couple of things. I'm going to drop my exposure back down just a little, but this time I'm currently at f13 aperture. Let's take that right open to f2.8. I've got a really shallow depth of field now. Let's have a look at what happens with our image. There we go, nice clean shot, no more flashing highlights. But most importantly, have a look at that background. So you can see we've got that lovely little blurred effect called bokeh, and that's because we've used a wide open aperture of f2.8. If I compare that to the previous image, you can see how much more in focus the background is. So this is just something creatively with your aperture that you can play around with when taking photos of small things. So just something a little bit different for people who like to get out, do a bit of nature. Yeah, get low to the ground, get a tripod, take a long exposure and mess around with your aperture, see what depth of field does to the image. And hopefully